Praise the Lord and good morning. I'm so delighted to share with you our word for today. I welcome you to our Sunday school service for today. And before we begin, I'd like for us to pray. Let us take some time and pray. Our Father and our Lord, we are grateful for an opportunity to hear from your voice today. Thank you for waking us up and showing us new mercies every morning. We praise you and we glorify you. We invite your presence as we start today's service, and we ask you to be with us from the beginning to the end. Walk with us, teach us, and help us to learn something new from your word and to be able to apply it in our lives. For it's in Jesus' name we do pray, trusting and believing. Amen. Thank you. And before we begin, I'd like you to join us as we sing this song. Today we'll share about hope. Jesus' power gives us hope. The main character that we are going to talk about today is Paul. And Paul was someone who was very zealous in the religious teachings of the Jews and Jewish tradition. And he's one of the people who persecuted the church and Christians a lot. At some instance, it's recorded that he is one of the people who were there when Stephen was being stoned to death. However, Paul in the later days encounters Jesus as he goes to Damascus and turns into a Christian. And Paul is so filled by the Spirit and is eager to share the gospel to these people around the world. One of the places he chose to go and preach was at the temple in Jerusalem. And there, when Paul is sharing the gospel, some men who are there were offended by the message of Jesus and the teachings of Jesus, and they got Paul to get arrested. And when Paul is arrested, he's taken to court. And at the court, they find out that Paul is a member or Roman nationality, and they have to try him in the courts in Rome. And this is where our story begins. They have to set voyage in a ship and send Paul from where they were to Rome. But before they set the voyage to go to Rome, Paul talks to the captain of the ship and the Roman soldiers and tells them that he feels that it is disastrous to go for this voyage. And it is in Acts chapter 27, verse 10. Paul perceived that the journey would be disastrous, but they didn't listen to him. They instead listened to the counsel of the captain of the ship. So they said, we will just sail and we will go. They failed to listen to Paul. When they were sailing, they encounter a storm. A great storm ravages the ship, and all people inside that ship are filled with fear because of the great storm that they are facing. And Paul is one of the people who are there. And while he is there, the angel of the Lord comes and gives Paul comfort and encouragement and tells him from at verse 27, from chapter 27, 22, it says, "By now I urge you to keep courage, because not one of you will be lost." Paul urges them that none of them will lose their lives, because that's the word that the angel gave him. And it continues to say, "Only the ship will be destroyed. Last night, an angel of God to whom I belong, whom I serve, stood beside me and said, 'Do not be afraid, Paul. You must stand trial before Caesar, and God has graciously given you the lives of all who sail with you. So keep up your courage, men, for I have faith in God that it will happen just as he told me.'" Paul was very, very confident in the word that God had given him. Paul decides to give the people who are inside that boat hope. And after they are given hope, their hearts are calmed and are at peace. However, they realize that they've come to a place where they are able to see land. There was a beach nearby. And they decided to say that those people who are able to swim should get out of the boat and swim. So they unshackled some prisoners. However, some of those, the people who were there, who were Roman soldiers, wanted to kill the prisoners, and one of them being Paul. But one centurion soldier who had favor with Paul chose to save his life. Let's read and hear what happened. Acts 27:43. "The soldiers planned to kill the prisoners to prevent any of them from swimming away and escaping. But the centurion wanted to spare Paul's life and kept them from carrying out their plan. He ordered those who could swim to jump overboard first and get to land. The rest were to get there on planks or on other pieces of the ship. In this way, everyone reached the land safely." So other guys who were able to swim jumped and swam to the shore, which was nearby. And others who did not know how to swim, because the ship had already started to get wrecked and broken, and there were pieces of wood here and there, they took the pieces of wood and would use them as floaters. And those who did not know how to swim would hold on to those pieces of wood and get to the shore. And that's how these people were saved. So God's word came to pass, that none of them lost their lives. In conclusion, in many ways, Paul was powerless. He didn't have any experience with sailing or as a sailor. The guards who held him in prison, that was something that made him feel helpless. He couldn't stop the waves or the storm. He was just a human being. But Paul had one thing going on for him. He had Jesus' power on his side. And this is the most amazing thing that I got to see from this story. In the same way, we also feel powerless. Sometimes we can trust Jesus' power in tough times. God promises to strengthen us with his power in times when it's tough, every time we call upon him. I'll share a story about myself in a fashion where I felt powerless. When I was a young child, we used to live in Naivasha, and I remember I was in nursery school. One day, we the custom was, we used to wait for a vehicle, which was a company vehicle, that would come to pick us from the school and take us home. But on that day, we did not, the vehicle came, was late because it was raining. Our elder brother chose to tell us to walk towards town and maybe try and find that car, which was a wrong decision to make. Then we ended up being in Naivasha town, lost, not knowing our way home, and it's raining heavily. We chose to sit somewhere near a certain shop, and as we were seated there, we sat there for a long time. But later, when it was starting to get dark, that's when my mom and my parents just came through and they found us there. I was so happy because we were lost and we were feeling abandoned and hopeless. So, like me, you have a story like that, something that happened to you. How about you? What's something in your life you feel powerless to do anything about? Is there something of the sort? Is there a story like that one? I want you to share with a friend near you, or your sibling, or your parents. I want us finally to pray about the issue that has made you feel powerless. Take some time and do that activity. Have you shared your story about a time when you felt powerless? Jesus' power actually makes a difference. In Psalms 31:24, which is our Bible verse for today, Psalm 31:24, it says, "So be strong and courageous, all you who put your hope in the Lord. Be strong and courageous, all you that put your hope in the Lord." In tough times and in times when we feel powerless, that's the time when we need to rely on Jesus' power to save us, Jesus' power to give us hope in those tough times.
Like we all know, last month, the month of April, was our VBS month, but we postponed. As we deliberate on the way forward, we have the VBS t-shirts on sale in church, and they're very beautiful, as you can see. They have our theme, Jesus' power pulls us through, and they also have a memory verse from Philippians 4 verse 13 that says, "I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me." We also have the mugs. The t-shirts are costing 700 each. We have the mugs as well, which are very beautiful, again with the same theme. We have the Rocky and our theme, very beautiful mugs that are costing 500 each. You can get all these things from the church office, and the church office opens from 8 to 5 from Monday to Friday.
Finally, I want us to pray for various categories of issues. One of them is the fears and anxieties, especially because of COVID-19 pandemic. And then I want us to pray for challenges at school and at home. If you have any challenges at school or at home, or those, we are now praying for those things that you guys talked about at home. I'll try to share and pray for you guys. And then I also want us to pray for children. All of us who are going back to school next week, we want to pray for that. We want to pray that the Lord will give us peace and hope amidst these tough times. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for your grace and your favor. Thank you for giving us an opportunity to share the gospel and to be able to hear your voice and to learn from you, Almighty God. We pray against the fears and anxieties, especially concerning COVID-19. and the pandemic that is going on around us. We pray that, Lord, you'll continue to sustain us. You'll continue to protect us and keep us from all harm. May you continue to walk with us and guide us in everything that we do. Father, we also pray for challenges that we have shared. Some of us have shared issues that are troubling them, things that are causing them to feel powerless. Lord, we pray that the power of Jesus, your power, Almighty God, will come through for us in a special way and cause us to have hope even amid this tough time. We also pray for ourselves as we go back to school next week, Father. We pray that you'll keep our hearts and our minds in peace, and that you'll give us hope even amid these tough times that we face. That as we go back to school, the transition will be amazing, and all of us will go back to our normal work and our normal school work, and all honor and glory will be given back to your name. Thank you for that amazing session that we've had today. We pray that the lessons that we have learned, we'll be able to teach them to others and also apply them to our lives. For it's in Jesus' name we do pray, trusting and believing. And everybody said, Amen.